Hey, would you like to know what are the best items to not be freezing cold when winter camping? Camping during winter time isn't pleasant if you're freezing cold. And I'm a really chilly person, and it took a few years to find out what was working really well for me, because obviously my husband isn't the same type of person, and he couldn't understand why I was so cold every time we were out there with the Defender camping, even though sometimes it wasn't that cold, but I just like to be like really cozy in a hot winter sleeping bag, for example, or like a huge coat with many layers underneath. But if you don't have the right layers underneath, you're gonna be freezing cold, and this is what I learned over the years. Here are my 7 favorite items and tricks to not freeze my butt off while we are out there camping with the Land Rover Defender. And put aside that we have a heater now, because we don't sleep with the heater on during the night, and for the previous 12 years, we didn't have any heater and we were going free camping and enjoying some weekends out during winter time and during the cold season. And not to say, sometimes during summer it was cold before. Yeah, maybe not last summer, but previous years we did have some quite bad summer weather. So here we go. The most important piece to enjoy cold weather while out there with your overland vehicle and camping is the base layer. I didn't wear a proper base layer for many years. I was wearing just regular clothes, trying either cotton or synthetic. And even though I had a really good sleeping bag, I was just freezing cold. There's my cat. Salut. And out of nowhere, we started to buy and invest, because it is expensive, a proper base layer, and it is merino wool. So here are a few items that I regularly use while we are out there with the Defender. And I can only tell you how this is a real game changer. I don't have that many pieces, but the ones I have are icebreaker. This is in my leggings and it is a heavy one, so it's 260. This is like the hottest one, I think. This is a jumper and it is also 260. And the base of the base, a long sleeve one, and this, there's no etiquette. I don't remember the name in English. Etiquette. It's gone off in the washing, but this one is 200. And I can tell you that these clothing are a real game changer to not be cold while out there. So if I have a larger pant, I know I can put my leggings underneath. And what I normally do, usually if we are just out for the weekend, I will just wear the same top that I sleep with. And like this, I'm all good and warm while outdoors, or warm when sleeping. What is also nice with these ones is that the sleeves are long. I mean, they're not short. I can just have them kind of over my hands, and the length is also nice like this. You can have them quite low and it's a good covering. Second most important item when free camping during winter is socks. A good pair of socks is important. We were using regular socks, regular cotton, or we also tried synthetic socks, and honestly, having merino wool socks is a real game changer. Again, I have the same brand as my base layer, so this is icebreaker socks, and these ones are heavy weighted socks, so really for the winter. And I would recommend going out with two pairs of socks like this. You can just change them for the night and have a dry pair of socks on your cold feet, and this will help you have a good night in your quite warm sleeping bag. I'm trying to find the next item. There, I've put a lot of mess on the floor. Here we go, next. The third item is having two beanies, two hats for your weekend out during winter time. Why two hats for the weekend? This is what I always do, because when you're out there during winter time, it can be snowing, it can be raining, or it's maybe humid while you're out there making the fire or whatever. If you go to bed in your tent, in your pop-up roof, in your vehicle, and you go with your wet hat, you're not gonna have a good night. I did it before, and when you wake up in the morning, if it's really cold, you're gonna have a freezing hat on your head. So what I do, and this is more a trick than a favorite item, is that I have a hat for sleeping and I have a hat for enjoying while I'm outdoors. Tell me if you do the same in the comments. For this next item, the fourth item, did I say? Fourth item to not freeze your butt out when you are winter camping. And what I like to have is this small down coat. So this isn't a base layer, it's a second layer, and it is extremely useful. You can have it on top of your base layer, you can have it under your big winter coat, you can have it for sleeping in your sleeping bag if it's really cold out there. I have this down winter coat. I didn't buy it for camping, I just had it. And the one I have is a Uniqlo, but my husband, he doesn't have the same one. He has the thermable liner coat and it's all synthetic. I like this one because I find it a little warmer than a synthetic one, but there you go, just have like this small coat and it is extremely useful. This is just a regular down jacket. It's not waterproof at all and it doesn't have a hoodie, and I wouldn't recommend taking a small coat with a hoodie, because without the hoodie you can use it as a liner coat under your bigger coat, and also if you use it for sleeping, I don't find it really comfortable or convenient to have a hoodie on the coat, neither on my merino wool jumper. Next item, this is a brand new item that I have purchased not so long ago. I have tested it outdoors. It's not especially made for sleeping, but it is extremely useful while outdoors, if it's cold, if it's windy, if it's snowy, whatever. I found one, just a second. These gloves, they are, I'm really impressed in fact. So they are mittens and gloves at the same time, and this was something I was really struggling, because when outdoors I like to have gloves when it's cold, because hands get cold really really quick, and being able to have my gloves on like this, keeping all my fingers warm, and then simply needing to do like this, and there's a small magnet so it stays here, I can use all my fingers. I can use my phone, I can use the camera, I can grab whatever I need to grab, and they are exceptional, I think, because I've used them when we were out not so long ago, and it was extremely extremely windy, and it was the first time I was using them, and honestly I can only recommend them. There you go. There you go. Fingers are usable for any situation, and voila, I'm cold, put them back in. The brand is Hestra, and they are Gore-Tex Infinity, Infinium, okay. Gore-Tex Infinium, so they are weatherproof, windproof, waterproof, breathable, and you can remove them easily with these two strings with your other hand. And as you saw before, you can uncover all of your fingers. There you go. Next important item to have to enjoy your winter camping or cold weather camping is having a good sleeping bag. And if you don't want to invest in a good sleeping bag because you feel that you wouldn't need it that much, sleeping bag liners are a real game changer too. I have an extremely hot sleeping bag because I am really chilly, and even with this sleeping bag, sometimes I'm cold. Yes, you're gonna say I'm crazy, but it's like that. So mine is a Land Rover. I'll put the reference down there, and I'm extremely happy with my bag, but it's extremely expensive. There you go. My husband, he has another sleeping bag, and he bought this one, the Sea to Summit Spark SP3, because when he went hiking during winter time and camping outdoors, he needed a smaller sleeping bag than this one to carry around in his backpack. So this is what he currently uses. Now for the kids, as we don't want to invest in a really expensive sleeping bags, you can call us bad parents, but they're growing up. We don't know if they will continue to come with us when they will be older. So obviously investing in some masterpieces, extremely expensive winter sleeping bags might be not a good idea. So they have their regular sleeping bags, which are these ones. That what is funny about these two sleeping bags, they have the same. We bought them in Australia. Yeah. And what they do is that they have a sleeping bag liner, and this one was also bought in Australia. And there are two types of sleeping bag liners that we have, and it is the heavy one, the heavy fleece one, and now we also have this smaller one, also by Sea to Summit. And what does these sleeping bag liners do is that they add more heat to your regular sleeping bag, and it doesn't take that much space in the car. So this is a real nice added item for your cold winter nights when outdoors. This is like the real winter sleeping bag. I'm supposed to go be able to sleep at the Himalaya with this. You can just close it and like only have your head coming out of this small hole, and then you can put this over your head and be extremely warm during your winter camping. And it is really warm. A tip from my husband, he said, never go out free camping or overlanding during winter time with some jeans, and because it will keep you cold. I don't know if you do it. I don't especially do it. I did sometimes, but I told him that worse than some jeans, because my daughter, she goes out with her jeans, is the worst is yoga pants. This is the worst clothing you can wear to go winter camping or just overlanding during cold season, because you're going to be freezing cold. The last item on the list, this is something in fact that I haven't used yet, but I bought recently for our winter cold weekends out, and this is the thermal pad. So do you know about these? I think that they might be life-saving. You just open back, have it in the air, and then it will warm up by magic, and they are supposed to stay warm for many hours. These ones, they say 12 hours. I have no idea if they stay warm 12 hours. And I also bought the ones for the feet. The downside of these ones is that they're not reusable. So you open the pack and then when it's finished, you just put it in the trash. And I don't know if this is good, but I did read that the reusable ones aren't that effective. Have you used this before? I don't know why I never bought this before, because in fact, as I'm a chilly person, this would be like a lifesaver, but who knows? So this was the last item on my list. I do hope that you enjoyed. I like to know what people use, so I hope that this will bring you some more ideas. If you have questions, comment below. I read every comment and try to answer all of them. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.